Kansas City selection on its choice from the LA Rams, John Ault, tackle, Iowa.
I'm a hard-working man. I wear a steel hard hat. I can ride rope, a hammer and paint. Do things with my hands that most men can't. I can't get ahead no matter how hard I try. I'm getting really good at barely getting by. I'm a hard working man. I got it all on the line for a piece of the promised land. Man.
John Ault to me is someone I met when I was in eighth grade. We were science partners and started dating when we were seniors in high school. We'll be married 30 years in June. He went from a very young, insecure, troubled, frustrated young kid to quite an accomplished grown up most of the time. Father of five fabulous children and a grandfather to two little ones. He started out with absolutely nothing, not a quarter in his pocket, and has accomplished a lot in his life, both financially and emotionally, grown up and become quite a nice husband and father.
I met John when I was in sixth grade. John was in fourth grade. The reason I remember that is because it was a football team that only allowed fifth and sixth graders. And of course, John was, as you see John now, big, and he was big for his age back then. Had to fabricate the age a little bit in order to be eligible to be on the team.
Well, during our high school years with John, he was very driven. He was very motivated, and you can tell at that time, even as a 15, 16-year-old sophomore coming in, that he was motivated to be successful. He was very disciplined. And one nice thing about John is that regardless of the situation, whether it be athletically or academically, the bigger the moment, the better that he played. He was just one of those people, whether something innately or something externally motivated him. But the biggest moments always brought out the best in John.
John was an individual who had dealt with adversity growing up. But he was always able to perform well academically. Obviously, he performed well athletically in any endeavor he ever pursued. And he is one of those people that I recognize why the school is honoring him as a distinguished alumni, because he overcame that adversity, and not only did he overcome it, but he overcame it at the highest levels. As a football player, I don't think that was his favorite sport. I think basketball, as I recall, was his favorite sport. And I think it was Ron Raveling, the head coach, at his senior year when John was looking at basketball. I know he had scholarship offers, basketball and football. Coach Raveling said, there's a lot of 6'8" talented athletes playing basketball. He says, I don't know of any 6'8" football players. So that's probably when he, decided he was going to be a football player. And I would guess that it was at the combines when they tested all those college athletes when he realized that he was probably the most naturally gifted athletic offensive lineman in the combine. So I'll say that John never will, but I think that's when he realized he could be a professional football player.
From the time I've known him, he's always been the big star athlete and more driven And so I think his career path absolutely fit him perfectly. And obviously his physical size helped him out tremendously with that goal.
John had a very, very interesting way, in my eyes, of handling his fame all throughout his athletic career. He was the most humble man that I ever knew. He never wanted to be in the spotlight. I think it came back from his roots and where he began from Columbia Heights and growing and I guess achieving what he did through all of his challenges. And another word that comes to mind with regards to his fame is generosity. John always had time for youngsters in football programs, whether he would go and speak in front of groups or whether he would donate an autographed football or jersey. And there are certainly times down in Kansas City where some of his teammates would joke that he just spent another one of his game checks on all of his friends and families that came down to watch him play at Arrowhead.
We're down in a game in Kansas City after the game, and for some reason we were out. It was just him and I grabbing something to eat, hadn't eaten all day, and so we went out and got a burger someplace, and I ate mine. I was really hungry, and he kind of gives me this strange look. He said, "I've never been beaten in a hamburger eating contest," and I didn't realize it was a contest. I was just hungry, and so that moment kind of stuck in my mind of how his thinking and how competitive he is and how he likes to do things the best.
Yeah, I don't think John ever sought the spotlight, but the reality is he couldn't really avoid it. When you walk into a room and you're 6'8" and have the widest shoulders of anybody you've ever seen, you get noticed. So people knew he was a professional athlete even if they didn't know who he was. As far as did that go to his head, it never went to his head. He's an individual who's very self-aware. He's aware of his strengths. He's aware of weaknesses. He, to this day, works on overcoming weaknesses and getting better every day. I'm proud of John for what he's accomplished, for being a self-aware individual, and for not letting the great blessings that have been given to him go to his head.
You couldn't ask for a better guy to be in that position. He was very unimpressed with the whole, pageantry and everything of the NFL, and it was a job to him. He wanted to be absolutely the best he could, but he would just as soon sit around with his friends in a back room just talking about the good old days or just talking about friends, but didn't affect him at all. He was so just normal, and it really made it real for the rest of the people that were around him.
John, I am so incredibly proud of you for receiving this award. Congratulations on who you were and who you've become, the part of Columbia Heights that was you and will always be you. Congratulations.